Hi everyone, Knowledge Academy welcomes you. In this video, we are going to discuss what is meant by sampling. Okay. So sampling is a process, it is used to convert an analog signal into digital signal. So it is a process involved in this conversion. When we apply sampling to an analog signal, that analog signal is converted into discrete signal. And through further processes like quantization and encoding, it is again converted into digital signal. Now in this video, we shall discuss about sampling in detail. Before entering into the video, kindly subscribe my channel, Knowledge Academy. Now let us enter into the video. Right. So here, this is an analog signal. This is the discrete signal of this analog signal. Otherwise, we call it as a sample signal. So here, when we do sampling to an analog signal, it is converted into a sample signal or discrete signal. That is, it is discrete in nature with respect to time, not with respect to amplitude. With respect to time, it is discrete in nature. Okay, it is not continuous, it is broken. Okay, so here, when we do this process will be helpful in converting that particular analog signal into digital signal, because we need the message signal to be digital in nature for digital communication. So for that, we have to do this conversion. Okay. So how do we do this conversion? How do we do this? How do we make this analog signal into discrete signal? There is only a single process that is involved. Okay, there is nothing but multiplication. We have to multiply two signals. So one signal is the analog signal which we have to process. Another signal, it is nothing but comb signal. We have to multiply the comb signal with the analog signal. When we do this multiplication, that analog signal will be automatically converted into a discrete signal. So what happens to that? What is the impact? What is the importance of this comb signal here? Now let us see. What is meant by comb signal? Comb signal is nothing but it is the summation of time shifted delta signal. Okay. So here again, what is meant by delta signal? Delta signal is the digital representation of an impulse signal. Again, what is meant by impulse signal? Impulse signal, it is a signal which has the pulse at time t equal to zero, and the amplitude of the pulse is infinity, whereas the energy within that pulse is unity. So we call it as unit impulse signal. Okay, the digital variation, we call it as delta signal. So delta signal means it should have the amplitude unity. Okay, so it is not an impulse signal. For impulse signal, the amplitude is infinity, but the energy within itself is unity. Whereas for delta signal, the amplitude itself is unity, because it is the digital variation, okay, digital representation of an impulse signal. So we call it as a delta signal. So here is a delta signal. Okay, it is a delta signal at time t equal to zero, right? Now, this is the delta signal. Time shifted by 1 unit, so we represent it as del of t minus ts. Okay, now again, this is time shifted delta signal by 2 units, time shifted by 2 units, so we represent it as del of t minus 2 ts. We have the pulse at this point at t equal to 2, and when we have the pulse at t equal to n, we represent it as time shifted by n units, and we call it as we represent it by del of t minus nts. Okay, so when we add all these signals, all these time shifted signals, okay, we'll be getting summation n equal to 0 to infinity del of t minus nts. So we are adding all these time shifted delta signals, we'll be getting comb signal. So this is comb signal. Okay, comb, it is it represents the structure of a comb, right? Not honeycomb, the comb which we use to comb our hair, right? So here, look at the amplitude. The amplitude is 1. Okay, whereas look at the duration at which the pulses are occurring at regular interval of time. There is a gap between two pulses. There is always a gap between two pulses. A constant gap is there. Okay, so when we multiply this comb signal with the analog signal which we have to sample, it can be converted into discrete signal. So now see what happens. Okay, right? So here we have the amplitude as 1, the first pulse, we have the amplitude 1, and that is multiplied with the analog signal. So we will be having, so the amplitude of the here analog signal is a sine wave. Okay, it is a sinusoidal signal, sine wave. So t equal to 0, the amplitude of sine wave is also 0. So 1 into 0 is 0. So we will have the pulse at this point. Okay. Now, the second pulse is at t equal to 1. It is multiplied with the sine wave. And that sine wave, the amplitude of the sine wave is multiplied with 1. So we'll be getting the amplitude of the sine wave here. Okay, so we'll not be getting 1, because 1 into anything is that particular number which we are multiplying. So here we are multiplying the amplitude of the sine wave with 1. So as a result, the final answer will be the amplitude of the sine wave itself. Okay, but look at here, there is a gap between the first pulse and second pulse. Okay, between first pulse and second pulse, there is a gap. So there is no signal there. At that juncture, the amplitude is 0. So 0 into anything is 0. That is why here in the output, in the result also, we are having a gap of 0. Okay, 0 into anything is 0. Okay, so like that, all the pulses are multiplied. Okay, all the pulses are multiplied with the analog signal. So we will be getting the resultant signal corresponding to the shape of the analog signal, the amplitude of the analog signal with intermediate gaps. Okay, so that is discrete signal. Okay, and one more thing, the pulses, the gap between the pulses should be very small. Okay, should be very small. So why it should be very small means, if the gaps are very large, then it is not possible to recover the original signal in the receiver side. Okay, if the pulses are very close, then it will be very easy to recover the signal. For example, when we have a sine wave like this, and we have the pulse like this, here one pulse, here one pulse, and when we multiply these two signals, we'll be getting the output like this and like this. Okay, so what happens? So here it is the reference line. Okay, so what happens, we'll be having one signal like this, one signal like this. Okay, so this is not equivalent to this original signal, analog signal. So it will not be possible to recover this original signal, the analog signal, from this discrete signal. Whereas if the pulses are very close, see, if the pulses are very close, if the pulses are very close. Now, what happens when we multiply? We'll be having the discrete signal like this. Here it is representing the original signal. Look at the shape. So we can easily recover the original signal. So we call this process as downsampling or upsampling. Okay, oversampling or downsampling through this. There is a particular thing when the actually there is a, it is an art of taking the sampling frequencies or sampling rate. Okay, so the sampling rate should be a sampling rate or sampling frequency, it should be very, very greater. It should be greater means there is a particular point, we call it as Nyquist rate. Okay, the analog signal sampled, the analog signal should be sampled at Nyquist rate. So Nyquist rate means it is the for example, if an analog signal which we have to sample is there, and we have to find the highest frequency component in that analog signal. Okay, so highest frequency component should be found, and that highest frequency component should be multiplied by 2. Okay, so we will be getting a value. Okay, with that value, we have to sample the signal. So that value should be taken as the sampling frequency or sampling rate. Okay, the reciprocal of this should be, this is a sampling period. Okay, so here the sampling rate should be very high. It should be equivalent to or greater than the twice the highest frequency component of the analog signal which we have to sample. Okay, so we call this as Nyquist rate. Okay, only if we sample that particular signal with this Nyquist rate, it can be recovered, as I mentioned earlier. Okay, when it is not sampled, when it is sampled at the rate lesser than the Nyquist rate, then we cannot recover. So we cannot recover means some errors will occur. Okay, the important error that will occur is aliasing occurs. Okay, so here when we sample the signal at a rate less than the Nyquist rate, we call it as downsampling. Due to downsampling, aliasing occurs. When we are sampling it with the rate higher than the Nyquist rate, we call it as oversampling. Oversampling does not cause aliasing and signal can be easily recovered. Okay, so at any point, the sampling rate should not be less than Nyquist rate, right? Okay, so I hope you understand what is meant by sampling. In further videos, we shall discuss what is meant by quantization and encoding and how an analog signal can be converted into digital signal and the other topics related with digital communication in English, because I have posted all the topics that come under digital communication in Tamil. Now we shall discuss all those videos in English. Okay, thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, kindly comment, share and like. Don't forget to subscribe my channel, Knowledge Academy. Meet you again in the next video. Thank you.